See, dear students, I want to discuss or tell few things about the Pinnacle-Pinnacolone rearrangement. It is actually a extension of the Pinnacle-Pinnacolone rearrangement, which is known as the semi-Pinnacle-Pinnacolone rearrangement. See, the semi-Pinnacle-Pinnacolone rearrangement, which is similar to the Pinnacle-Pinnacolone rearrangement, see, is the extension of Pinnacle-Pinnacolone rearrangement. It is given in the last test. See, while discussing, I told that is the semi-Pinnacle-Pinnacolone rearrangement. By taking the 2-3 examples, I would like to introduce the concept of the semi-Pinnacle-Pinnacolone rearrangement. See, first you should know the what is Pinnacle-Pinnacolone rearrangement. This is semi-Pinnacle-Pinnacolone rearrangement. See, actually you know that. So I don't want to explain the Pinnacle-Pinnacolone rearrangement. You know. What is Pinnacle? 1-2 diol. Di-tertiary 1-2 diol is called as the Pinnacle. It is a name like phenols and carboxylic acid. It is the name of the particular diols. That is, but they must be. See, we have taken, always we take the methyl OH. This is methyl. This is methyl. This is which is known as the Pinnacle butane 2,3 diol. 2,3 dimethyl butane 2,3 diol. This is carbonyl carbon. This is tertiary carbon. This whole is alcoholic group is tertiary. Di-tertiary, both are di-tertiary diols. So actually, Pinnacle-Pinnacolone rearrangement is proposed on 1-2 di-tertiary diols, which are known as the class of compounds, are called as the Pinnacles. See, here dilute H2SO4 is used, or H2SO4 is used in the acid media. It undergoes this rearrangement to give the methyl, tertiary butyl methyl ketone. This is the rearrangement process. Wagner-Milwin rearrangement is here. You know the mechanism. It is protonates the one of the alcohol groups OH. This is OH2+. This is methyl. This loses the water and converts into the that is methyl OH. This is the methyl. So carbocation formation is the important step. One is protonated and carbocation is formed. Now the rearrangement is taking place like this. This is going like this. This is migrated here. I am taking both the things at a time. That is methyl. This is double bond OH+. This is methyl migration. This this is losing the -H+ ion, and this is the intermediate formed during the reaction, and one of the group is migrated. So if you take the any other thing, that is pH symmetrical pH, the all groups need not be same. This on treatment with the H+ ion, that is dilute H2SO4. All these things you know, the unnecessary. This is pH, I am trying to revise this. This is the pH, protonation followed by loss of water. This is formed. This undergoes rearrangement to give the, that is pH double bond O, that is pH triphenyl methyl phenyl ketone is formed. This is the pinacalcanecalone rearrangement. If there are different this thing and so and real migrating abilities and all these things, you know. Now what is the semi-pinacalcanecalone rearrangement? To understand the semi-pinacalcanecalone rearrangement, you should know about the and pinacalcanecalone rearrangement principle or the intermediate involved. See, there must be two OH groups on the adjacent carbon atoms. On treatment with the acid, one of the OH group is protonated and last carbocation is formed. Now the what the methyl group is migrating like this. That is the Wagner-Meyrin rearrangement migrating. See, now what we are doing in the semi-pinacalcanecalone rearrangement, you are not starting with the pinacal. But this is the OH, there will be one OH, in place of the other OH, the some other group is introduced. Some other group is introduced. And by using the appropriate reagent through that group, carbocation is formed. Carbocation is generated. Ultimately, the intermediate will be same. Now, that is called as the semi-pinacalcanecalone rearrangement. See here, methyl, OH. See, this is the pinacal. Instead of this, see, now I am taking the bromine. So now treat this with the, that is here, through this carbocation can be generated. So through the CX bond, carbocation can be generated by treating with the, this is a tertiary. So tertiary carbocation is more stable. Treat with the silver ion, that is silver nitrate. So this is the lone pair donation to the this one. There is a relation, that's the affinity between the silver ion and the halide ion. That is, this takes the word bromine and helps in the formation of, that is methyl OH, that is, and carbocation is formed. Let me write here. See, please, let me write here. This phenyl, methyl, that is OH. This is the methyl. You can may understand better way. This on treatment, the methyl only. That is, it has its own name. That's a silver ion is used. That is silver nitrate. This is converting to the, this is removing this and producing the, this is giving this, this is giving. Once this carbocation is generated, the product will be same. Right? Product will be same. Now this is called as the, it's not a pinacal, but it is, the product is same. It is behaving like a pinacal in the reaction. Therefore, or else you can use the AlCl3. What is there? AlCl3 is the, you know, that is the halogen carrier. Through the CX bond, carbocation can be generated by removing the halogen from the carbon. This is generated. This is from this, it is converted into this form. This is semi-pinacalcanecalone rearrangement. You can use the best way is the silver halide is the insoluble in the water. That is the more driving force is more towards the forward reaction. Better to use the word silver nitrate if it is a tertiary halide. That is, silver ion removes the tertiary halide ion from the carbon and generates this one. So now what we can do, and we can take the what other one. This is the same methyl OH. This is the methyl. This is methyl. Instead of this, we take the fluorine. Fluorine is can be used. So this is same. Fluorine can be removed. Halogen can be removed. What is the reagent required? Silver fluoride is soluble in the water. Remember, silver fluoride, bromide and iodide are insoluble. But silver fluoride is soluble in the water. Then what you have to do is, that is, and this is gives the this one. This is SbF5. So it takes the fluorine and convert it to the SbF6- and creates the same carbocation. So that is, in place of the one of the OH group, the other group is present, which generates the carbocation on that carbon by using the and that is appropriate reagent. Now if I take the, this is Br. Now you can take the tosylate, TS. Tosyl paramethyl benzene sulfonyl chloride is called as the tosyl chloride. OH is tosylate and is a better living group. Now it is a better living group. This on treatment with the OH minus ion, you get the, that is, it behaves like a, this one. Methyl, this is methyl. Migration, this is formed. What is happening? See, the mechanism is base is thrown, treated with the base. This is converted into the, this one. Methyl. Tosyl group is the OH becomes better leaving group when it is treated with the toluene sulfonyl chloride. Tosylation, desylation, triflatation. That is, and now it is converted into the, that is, this is converted into the O minus. This is, this is same OTS. OTS, methyl here. Now it is coming like this. This is shifted here. Let me write the OTS. This is methyl. This is going out, and anyhow, methyl, same product, methyl. This can be tosyl group, methyl group, that is TF, triflatation, triflate ion, that is trifluoromethyl sulfonate ion. So these are the better leaving groups. If you come to the other one, this is the methyl, this is OH. Here the same pinacol is taken, but now semi-pinacol on rearrangement, this one of the OH is removed with the, replaced with the other thing. What you have to take here, that is NH2 group. It is easy to create the, that is, carbocation through the NH2 group by treating with the NaNO2. So this to be converted into the, this is NaNO2 plus HCl nitrous acid. You know that the aliphatic primary amines are converted into the, this is the MeMeOH. This is, and now it is converted into the N2 plus, this is methyl. This is the super living group, that is, the living tendency, molecular nitrogen is the coming out. What is the group coming out? Molecular nitrogen is the living group. This is super living group. The readily moves, and without your permission, that is, this is methyl, OH. This is methyl, this is the carbocation is formed. This leads to the, so same carbocation, that is, which is formed here. The same carbocation is formed. See, this and this is same. So now what happens? Migration takes place from here to here is same. Look, this is the amino group. Alpha to the carbonyl carbon, there must be amine group, primary amine group. Primary aliphatic primary amines lose their, that is, create the, on treatment with the nitrous acid, create the carbocation. So in the primary amine, aliphatic primary amines, we discuss aliphatic primary amines on treatment with the nitrous acid and NaNO2 plus HCl, that is, alcohol is produced, nitrogen gas is liberated. That is, diazotization takes place, diazotic ion is formed, that is, aliphatic diazotic ion is unstable, that goes out and creating the carbocation that undergoes rearrangement here. And now if you take the other thing, that is, this is the methyl OH, this is methyl double bond, methyl. This is the other one. This is treated with the acid. So what happens? This is protonated methyl C, no, methyl, methyl OH. See addition of the, say the word HCl. So proton addition takes place. Electrophilic addition reaction, Me, this is the positive charge. This is the methyl, methyl, that is hydrogen is attached to this. H plus ion, and that is a carbocation generated here. Now this is the carbocation. Now what is happening? This is a rearrangement. That is again double bond O. This is also, that is phenacol. This is methyl, methyl. This is a methyl, methyl. This is the original. This is the group migrated from here to here. So this is also semi phenacol, phenacol on type rearrangement. So this is called as the phenacol, phenacolone type, semi-phenacol, phenacolone type rearrangement. That's all.